If you're in the sciences, then chances are memorizing the polyatomic ions will probably be one of the more challenging memory tasks that you will face during your academic career. Heck, chances are you're watching this the night before a major exam, just trying to figure out how to hack it. But in this video, I'm going to show you how I, a lowly sociology major with no aptitude toward science whatsoever, can memorize them easily and quickly using three simple steps. And by the end of this video, you'll have a neuroscientifically proven method for memorizing anything your teachers can throw at you. Let's face it, memorizing the polyatomic ions or any other chemical formula is hard. In fact, it's so hard that 50% of the Wikipedia page for polyatomic ions is comprised of tips on how to memorize these confusing formulas. I bet you've never seen that before. Now, as an online instructor in accelerated learning with over 150,000 students in every field of study imaginable, I get asked a lot. Jonathan, how can I memorize scientific or mathematical formulas? But look, I'm not even going to lie. As a sociology major turned entrepreneur, I don't even fully understand what the polyatomic ions are or why they matter. After all, I spend all my time speaking, writing books, and teaching online courses about memory and learning. So what do I care about chemical formulas? Fortunately, with the right system for learning and memorizing them quickly and easily, that actually doesn't even matter. And as you'll see in this video, my complete novice status as a chemist didn't stop me from being able to quickly and easily memorize the polyatomic ions in a lasting and memorable way. Here's the thing. If you look at a lot of the videos, tips, and advice all over the web, it all offers you either a simple mnemonic about Nick the baby camel, which only helps you learn a few of the polyatomic ions, or another complicated scheme for converting from the 8 polyatomic ions to the 8 polyatomic ions and so forth. It's not ideal. For example, if you add per to the front, you add one more oxygen to the 8 form, or if you convert from 8 to 8, you have one less oxygen ion, and so on and so forth. Now, I'm not going to stand here and tell you not to use these techniques, because in reality, they can be really helpful in teaching you to convert the ions yourself. But if you create visual mnemonics like the ones you're just about to learn in this video, to remember those rules, they can really cut down on the amount of work that you actually need to do. And I know that's important for those of you who have the exam tomorrow. The problem with these memorization tactics that are normally taught is that they depend on you first learning the basic 8 ions, which you'd have to do with boring old rote memorization, just like your great-great-grandpa did. And even still, they do nothing to prevent you from forgetting a bunch of the 8 versions and therefore forgetting entire groups and entire formations of polyatomic ions. So what you need is a method that makes it quick and easy to at least, at the very least, memorize the 8 polyatomic ions and their formulas in order so that you can be sure not to leave one of them out. Once you do that, you can either use the same system to memorize the per, hypo, ite, and so on versions of the polyatomic ions, or you can then fall back on the nomenclature conversion tricks if you have to. In order to memorize this stuff quickly and easily, we have to think out of the box and instead rely on the incredible power of visual memory. You see, the human brain has, in fact, evolved to memorize huge amounts of data. It just isn't used to doing it in an auditory or text-based way. Think about it. Your ancestors, 100,000 years ago, knew the name, medicinal value, and season of every plant and animal in their environment. And they were able to memorize generations of rich tribal history. How is that possible? Well, if you want to improve your memory, you need to remember a few basic principles. First, Our brains are subject to something called the picture superiority effect. This means that even if you think you're an auditory or tactile kinesthetic learner, research has actually proven that in fact, your brain remembers pictures better than anything else. Rule number two, our brains operate by something called Hebb's Law, which states that neurons that fire together wire together. In plain English, this means that connecting new information to information we already know makes it more memorable and relevant to your brain, which will place a higher priority on it. And finally, rule number three. Our brains are insanely good at remembering locations. This is why the memory palace technique, a system of creating unique, memorable pictures and imaginarily placing them into real-world places that your brain already knows, is used by every single memory champion and world record holder. In fact, I recently put out a video explaining the exact neuroscience behind the memory palace technique and how the heck it works so incredibly well for everybody. Okay, now that we understand these three basic tenets of memory improvement, let's try it out by tackling some of these scary polyatomic ions. As I go along, what I'm going to do is create a unique visual symbol for each polyatomic ion. That's rule number one. And then these symbols will use interesting, bizarre imagery to make it interesting and original for my brain. In fact, I might even choose to use violent or sexual imagery, but don't worry, these images are just for me and your images are just for you. You don't have to share them with anyone else. As I do this, I'm going to be extra careful to connect these images to other pieces of knowledge, creating at least two or three connections to pre-existing knowledge. That is rule number two. I'll try to incorporate visual elements that I already know, or even connect it to people or things that are emotionally relevant for me personally. That's why any list of visual markers I could create for you is ultimately not nearly as successful as just doing it yourself. Finally, for remembering rule number three, I'll find a logical way to organize the polyatomic ions into a location that I know very well, such as my favorite grocery store, my bedroom, or even my entire house. Before I show you all some examples, and before you see how incredibly effective this actually is, I want you to stop for a moment and think. How is this different than the way you've been learning up until now? Is it more interesting and engaging than trying to memorize a list of meaningless names and formulas and symbols, or less so? Let me know in the comments below. Okay, so on to some examples. Let's start with a really basic one from the 8 family, chlorate. Instead of just trying to do rote memorization, I'm going to think about a chlorine dispenser my dad used in the pool when I was growing up. Now, he was always yelling at my friends and I not to play with it or get close to it because I think he was probably afraid what would happen if I ate the chlorine. Inside of this chlorine dispenser, I'm going to visualize 3 little balls which are in the place where my dad used to put those chlorine balls. But these aren't chlorine balls. They're actually clear. They look completely different. And that's because these are the 3 oxygen atoms in chlorate. Now, I just need to place this complex visual symbol in a logical place in my memory palace. Depending on what I need to memorize this information for, I might do it differently. For example, if I need to group them by alphabetical order, I might create a linear journey through my memory palace and then memorize the entire list of polyatomic ions in order, placing one symbol on every major piece of furniture, or windowsill, or doorway even, along my entire journey. Now, on the other hand, if I just need to memorize the list and I don't care too much about where they go, I might actually put things in their logical place that reinforces and reminds me of the symbol by leveraging a pre-existing memory. For example, putting that chlorine dispenser into my childhood pool on the side where it used to always get caught in the filter. Another way to do it would be to pick a room or area in my memory palace for specific letters of the alphabet. For example, putting all the polyatomics ions that start with C or K into the kitchen and putting all of the polyatomic ions that start with B into the master bedroom. For now, I think I'm going to keep that chlorine dispenser in the pool where I personally won't forget it or its three little clear oxygen items inside. Anyways, I don't need to know them in alphabetical order, and plus, because I now know chlorate, I can either choose to make additional memorable symbols for chloride, hypochlorite, perchlorate, and so on, or I can just use the easy-to-follow rules about adding and removing oxygen atoms based on their name. Wow, I've already memorized 5 polyatomic ions with just one visual symbol. See how effective this is? Well, let's give it another go. By memorizing nitrate. In this situation, I'm going to lean on a piece of pre-existing knowledge about a specific memory that I have. See, years ago, when I learned about nitrates, at the time, I was dating a girl, and she was telling me why I should stop eating lunch meat, because it is full of unhealthy nitrates. I might picture myself with 3 round sticks of delicious deli ham sticking out of my mouth, except instead of being pink and normal, they're clear because they are those 3 oxygen atoms in nitrate. Now, for the sake of logic, I'm going to put this in the refrigerator of the same childhood house where the pool and the chlorine dispenser are. Now, using the same naming rules as before, I know how to write the formulas for nitrate and nitride, and I might just create another visual symbol for remembering hyponitride and pernitrate, which are special exceptions. Now, this strategy will take you very, very far, allowing you to easily memorize the basic polyatomic ions in literally minutes, from sulfate to phosphate and even cyanide, which I remember by picturing a mysterious Chinese spy, CN, chewing on a negatively charged cyanide pill after getting caught. Super easy, right? But what about the more complex polyatomic ions with the more challenging formulas? Ones like citrate, whose formula is C6H5O33-. Well, for this, we'll use an even more advanced formula of creating compound visual markers within the stations of our memory palace. In other words, using individual details of the visualized image to add details within one complex compound visualization. Think of it a bit like compressing more information into one symbol. Here's how I'd do it, and try visualizing it with me as we go along. C6, for me, brings up a particularly sexy and exciting image of a Corvette Model C6. In that Corvette, a beautiful model is driving by a crowd of adoring fans, giving everyone a high five. Now, remember how I said that obscene and sexual imagery often works better than any other kind? Well, as she drives by her fans, 7 people in the audience spontaneously experience, you guessed it, a big O. The police see this and understand that it's completely inappropriate in public, and so they give her -3 points on her driving record. Now, you might be wondering, how am I remembering that it's 7 people who have that awkward O? Simple. I'm picturing that there are 4 on one side of the vehicle and 3 on the other side. Or how about the -3 points? Why did I choose that visualization? Well, because I'm relying on my pre-existing knowledge that I learned during a particularly unpleasant interaction with a police officer when I was speeding, whereby I learned that the maximum number of points you can get in California for any traffic offense is 3 at a time. You see, not only is my visual marker extremely bizarre and memorable, but more importantly, it borrows from images and visualizations that I personally already know, such as the design of the C6 Corvette, which has emotional meaning to me, such as the number of points I can get if I drive too fast, and then I leverage these types of visualizations and associations that come naturally to me, such as picturing high fives for H5. And by the way, I don't shy away from using inappropriate or nasty images, such as people in the crowd having a very inappropriate and awkward response to getting their high five. But wait, Now that I know the formula of this polyatomic ion, how do I remember the name? Well, that's an easy one, too. See, I just think of whatever comes to mind when I think of citrate, for example, a citrus fruit, or my friend Nate's head, and I put him in the passenger seat of the Corvette, an accessory to the crime. Citrate. Or better yet, I could just rely on another form of pre-existing knowledge, if I have one. For example, I happen to know that the magnesium supplement that I like taking every day, which coincidentally comes in citrus flavor, contains magnesium citrate. So to remember that this is the visual symbol for citrate, I might just put the logo of the brand that makes it, Natural Calm, all over the outside of the Corvette in the same way that Formula One cars have Motorola logos and all kinds of different sponsors plastered all over them. Now, I know it sounds complicated, but with a little bit of practice, creating these types of creative, visual, complex symbols can become second nature. By doing so, I can memorize each polyatomic ion, or any other kind of scientific formula, or anything else for that matter, in a matter of seconds, placing that compound visual image into the appropriate place in my memory palace and moving on to the next one. In time, this becomes as quick and as easy as snapping your fingers. And the best part, you will be able to cut your review time by as much as 80% because memorizing this way is not only a heck of a lot more fun, it's also way more memorable. Instead of trying to memorize a deck of boring flashcards by repeating them over and over and over again, you can imagine yourself walking through one of your favorite places in the world, picturing lewd models, driving sports cars, protective ex-girlfriends slapping lunch meat out of your hand, and dangerous chlorine dispensers with oxygen atoms inside of them. Now, you try it. I'd love if you took a moment to name a polyatomic ion in the comments and share what you might visualize in order to remember its formula. I'll go ahead and I'll share my feedback on how you did. It's actually much easier than you think. Now, I realize that this has been a pretty intense and fast-paced introduction to the rich world of memory enhancement and mnemonic techniques. So if you still need a little bit of help or you're still feeling a little bit confused, maybe you're just intrigued or just want to learn more about how to leverage these techniques, I want to encourage you to not just subscribe to our channel and hit that little bell icon, but also check out this completely free one-hour training session where I'll go into a bit more of the neuroscience behind how and why this stuff actually works with plenty more examples of how you can use it in your day-to-day life.